Everyone, this is Ashley. Thank you for joining us for our cardio workout today. Before we get started, just a quick reminder that you're responsible for your own health and safety throughout this workout. Take breaks when needed, modify any movements that you need to, and have a great workout. We're excited to share our mission today through our cardio workout by providing life-changing opportunities for sports and physical activity to individuals who are blind and visually impaired. And we are going to get started. So, cardio workout today, it's going to be a cardio jumping workout. So I like to call it the cardio jump-a-thon because we're going to be doing about 20 minutes straight through of cardio, no breaks, moving breaks. So it's going to be a little bit different. With that, I would just like to say, again, make sure you're going at your own pace. This is not a distance challenge. It is do what your body feels good and take breaks if you need to. So I'm going to explain the sequence that we have, and then we are going to get into it. So we can start with first our warm-up. So my body hasn't been moving in a little bit. I'm just going to start by walking in place on my yoga mat. I'm just going to walk a few steps to my left and then a few steps to my right. You can add in some arm swings while you're walking just to get my body moving, because we're going to be doing quite a lot of jumping and moving different parts today. So just get a gentle warm up in first. And next I'm going to go to a low impact burpee. So don't worry, this is just the warm up burpee. I'm going to start at the end of my mat. So I have plenty of space in front of me. My feet are going to be shoulder width apart. I'm just going to reach my hands up towards the ceiling. And I'm going to slowly bend at my waist so I get my fingers as close to the floor as possible. I'm going to walk my hands out until my body is in a high plank position. So my back is just straight. You can just walk out to wherever feels good. And then I'm going to walk my hands back towards my feet into a squat position and then stand up out of it. So very low impact burpee. I'm just kind of stretching and moving my body. I'm gonna do another one. My feet stay where they are, reaching up towards the ceiling and then folding at the waist and just walking out my hands slowly so I can feel the stretch in my hamstrings and in my quads and my back. And then when I'm in that high plank position, I'm just gonna slowly walk my hands back to my feet. You can bend your knees and get in that squat position and then just stand up. It's a good way to get some different parts of your body moving. Next up, I have trunk twists. So I'm going to stand with my feet shoulder width apart again, and I'm not going to move my feet, but I'm going to twist my core so that my chest is facing to the right. And then I'm going to twist to the other side. So now my chest is facing to the left. My hands are just at my side, or you can bend your elbows, and make a 90 degree angle with your arms and just slowly twist your core and your trunk from left to right without moving your feet, so you can get that stretch in your back and in your core. And then when that feels good, I'm just going to do some neck semicircles. So I'm going to bring my right ear to my right shoulder, arms at my side, and then I'm going to slowly draw a circle with my nose, bringing my chin to my chest, and then my opposite ear to my opposite shoulder. And then I'm going to go back the other way. So now my left ear is at my left shoulder, chin to chest, just doing some semicircles, stretching out my neck. And after I do that a few times, once you are feeling good, continue to warm up if you need while I describe our workout today, or you can follow along with me. So like I said, we have a cardio jump-a-thon sequence today. So what that's going to look like is I have seven different jumping cardio movements. And then in between each round of exercise, we're going to come back to our base movement. Our base movement when we're doing this workout is going to be jumping rope. So for that one, I'm going to just pretend like I'm holding an end of two ends of a jump rope, and I'm just going to move my arms My elbows are bent, so my arms are at a 90 degree angle. I'm holding the pretend jump rope, so my palms are facing towards the ceiling. There's not going to be a lot of movement from my arms, but just from my wrists, I'm going to move them clockwise at the same time, like I am moving a jump rope clockwise. So then as I'm making my hand movements for jumping rope, I'm going to add my feet into the jump rope. So this is where you can get a little creative with it. You can do one jump rope. You can do 1 foot at a time. So you're more like walking while you're jumping rope. You can add two jumps and go slower. Whatever you feel is your base speed for a jumping rope movement. Again, I don't have a jump rope. I'm just using my pretend jump rope and going at the speed that feels good for me. So that means as fast or as slow as you want, as much as you want to do it. This is going to be our base moving recovery. So once you come back to your jumping rope, and I will give you that cue, you do your pretend jump rope in whatever capacity you would like. Remember, when you are jumping, you want to land with your soft knees and not with straight legs. So when I jump, I just land and my knees have a slight bend in them so that I can continue jumping and I'm not hurting my knees. So our base movement will be jump rope. Instead of a rest, we will be jumping rope. So take that and you can do with it what you want. Again, faster or slower, depending on your speed. Now for the movements, our first one is going to be a pop squat with a 180 degree turn. So for this one, I'm going to start in the center of my mat. My feet are going to be shoulder width apart. I'm going to start in my squat position. So I'm going to sit back like I'm sitting back into a chair. I don't want my knees to go over my toes. So I'm really pushing my hips back and sitting down into the chair. And then when I come up out of my squat, I am going to jump up and turn to my left 180 degrees. So now I am facing the wall to my left. At first I was center. Now my toes are pointed towards my left and I'm going to squat down again. And when I come up out of this one, I'm going to come back, pop squat, back to center. So now my feet are facing my 12 o'clock where I started. And once I get back to here, I'm going to squat back down. And then this time I'm going to go to my right when I stand back up. So pop up, land back facing my right wall. So you're just doing a squat. And when you come back up, you are jumping and turning 180 degrees to your left, back to center, and then to your right. An option with this one, you don't have to do the jump. You can squat, stand up, and then turn, squat down, stand up, and then turn without the jump if you do not want to do the jump. So just a modification for that. If not, you squat down, come up, jump, face the other wall, 180 degree turn. So that is your pop squat, 180 degree turn. So after we would do that one, we would get back into our base of jump rope. The next up, we have a burpee. So for this one, you can do burpees like we did in the warm-up, the low impact burpee, where you're not putting too much pressure on your body, or you can do a burpee along with me. So for this one, I'm gonna start at the edge of my mat. So I have a lot of space in front of me. I'm going to squat down, and then I'm going to walk my hands out. So I'm in that low plank position. I'm gonna jump my feet back. So an option for this one, when you come down, you can walk your feet back one at a time, or you can jump your feet back into that high plank position. So I'm gonna jump my feet back. I'm gonna bring my chest to the floor. So not a push up, just bringing my chest to the floor so that my body and my stomach is resting on the mat. Then I'm gonna push back up. I'm gonna jump my feet back towards my hands, or you can step them one at a time towards your hands. So I'm jumping my feet, my toes towards my hands. My hands are under my shoulders. And then I'm gonna stand back up, and that's one. Then you're gonna repeat that cycle again for a burpee. So once I stand back up, I'm gonna bring my hands down to the mat. I'm gonna walk my feet or jump my feet back into that high plank position. I'm bringing my stomach and my chest down to the floor. You can do a push-up if you want, but I'm just bringing my chest to the floor. Then I'm coming back up. I'm bringing my toes to my hands. So I'm jumping my toes to my hands, and then I'm standing back up. That is burpee. And then in between that one, we have the jump rope rest. Next up, we have jump lunges. So for this one, I'm going to stand in the center of my mat, my feet starting off shoulder width apart. I'm going to start with my left leg. So I'm going to step my left leg forward and my right leg slightly behind me. I'm going to bend my right leg. So I'm lunging down. My right knee should bend, but it should not touch the mat. So I'm bending down to lunge. My left leg, my knee is not going over my left toes. So I'm in a lunge position. And then for a jump lunge, to switch to the next leg, I am going to jump, switch my feet. So there's a brief period of time where both of my feet are off of the mat. And then I'm going to land in my lunge position, opposite leg forward this time. So now my right leg's forward and my left leg's back, and I'm lunging. So switch. And then you have a jump in the middle option for this one. You can just walk lunge. So you lunge, stand up, both feet on the ground, and then switch legs, lunge back with the opposite leg if you don't want to add the jump component in the middle. After that one, we have butt kicks. So for butt kicks, I'm just going to stand in the center of my mat, feet shoulder width apart. The back of your heel is going to kick up to reach the back of your leg, so near your butt, and alternating. So my right heel towards the right of my the back of my right side, and then switch, my left heel comes up to try to kick the back of my left side. And this is just alternating. So with butt kicks, you can take this again as slow or as fast as you'd like. So you're just either walking in place, or you can get a little bit faster to emulate that running motion with butt kicks. And then next, we have three more. We have a squat jump. So this one, I'm starting in my squat position. So this is like the first pop squat, except no turn this time. So you're just feet shoulder width apart. You're sitting back into your squat position. Knees are not going over your toes. And then you're going to stand up, jump at the top, and then come back down into your squat. So every time you come up, you're jumping and then sitting right back down into that squat. Options for this one, again, you don't have to add the jump. You can just do free bodyweight squats with your feet on the ground. All right, next one is jumping jacks. So for this one, I'm going to start with my feet a little bit closer together. And to do a jumping jack, I'm going to extend my legs and my arms at the same time outward. So right now I'm standing in an I formation, so my body kind of is just like a pencil. And then I'm going to make an X with my legs and with my arms. So I'm extending my right leg out, my left leg out, my right arm out, my left arm out. So now my body's in an X. And then I'm going to bring them back together into the starting position, which is an I, and then out in that X position. And you're just repeating that motion for jumping jacks. Again, take this one as slow or as fast as you'd like. The speed is up to you throughout all of these workouts. And then the very last one is high knees. So standing in the center of my mat, I'm just bringing one knee up towards the ceiling until it's in a 90 degree angle, my leg and my body, and then bringing it back down and repeating on the other side. So kind of like I'm marching in place is high knees. You can take this one slow, so it's like you're marching, or you can go faster again to get make it look more like you're running. So that is up to you. Those are all of our movements throughout this exercise. I know that took a little bit longer to describe, but please go back in the video if you have any questions. I will be giving cues throughout our workout as well. So I'm gonna grab a sip of water. and then we are going to get started. So just a reminder, I will be prompting you with the time and what's up next, but we have our 90-second base, where is our jump rope. So that is our moving recovery, our moving cool down is your jump rope. That's going to be for 90 seconds. So use that as your recovery in between these exercises. Stop if you have to, go as fast or as slow as you would like to. And then when we get into our exercise movement, that will be for 60 seconds. So 90 seconds active recovery, 60 seconds of exercise. All right, I am going to start my timer. And
starting your
Tabata. We are starting with jump rope in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. And we are doing the jump rope for 90 seconds.
Let me go. Strung out on a feeling. My hands are tied.
You have 1 minute left of jump rope.
Oh, I can't control it. I can't control it. I try to replace it.
About 30 more seconds of jump rope until we move on to our first exercise. And in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, we're gonna go into our pop squat. So now we're squatting down, jumping up, turning 180 degrees, squatting back down, turning 180 degrees. Take this as slow or as fast as you need to. Thirty more seconds. Great job. And 10 more seconds. And 3, 2, 1, and recovery into jump rope. Remember, this jump rope can be at the speed that you want it. So right now, I am doing a slow step in my jump rope. So kind of like I'm walking in place slowly, but just lifting my knees up so it can get under my feet, can get under that imaginary jump rope. And try to catch your breath, slow your breathing. More seconds. Don't forget, we're using this as a recovery, so definitely go at the speed that you need to so you can catch your breath. Next up, we have our burpee in about 10 seconds. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And now we're getting into burpees. Remember, you can do the low impact burpee or regular burpees. Add the modifications that you need. Great job. More seconds. If you have to switch halfway through from low impact, that's totally fine. Keep it up, keep your body moving. 10 more seconds. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And we're back to our jump rope. Try to catch your breath. Use this as a cool down. My jump rope is going very slow. I'm doing one leg at a time. Got another minute left of recovery. If you're feeling good, try to move a little bit faster. Now I'm gonna jump on 2 feet. Still going slow. About 15 more seconds. Three, two, one. Now we're into jump lunges. So I'm gonna start with my left leg forward, right knee, right leg back, bend my leg, and then jump to switch. Both feet come off of the air, and then switch again. Remember, you can just walk it back and switch if you don't want to add the jump. Great job. Breathing heavy, 30 more seconds. And 10, almost done. And 3, 2, 1. And rest, active rest. Back to your jump rope. Focus on your breathing. Try to catch your breath with your jump rope. I'm going slow, 1 foot at a time. Like I'm kind of like I'm marching, but my knees are coming up to get my pretend jump rope under them. In about 30 seconds, we are on to butt kicks. See if you can pick up the pace from your jump rope if you're feeling good. We're about halfway through. We're doing great. All right, and 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now we're on butt kicks. Heel to back, heel to back. take this at the speed you want, but make sure your heel is touching the bottom. If you go a little faster, you can add your running arms into it. Thirty more seconds. I know we weren't perfect, but I never felt this way for no one. And I just can't imagine how you could. 10 seconds. And 3, 2, 1. Back to our active recovery, our jump rope. Active recovery is important because it helps us regulate our breathing and our heart rate while we're still moving and we're still keeping our body loose. We're doing a great job. Remember, this can be at your own pace. Just try to keep your body moving. More seconds of our active recovery. Next up, we have our squat jumps. So this one is like the top squat, but no turn. So just squatting down and then jumping when you get to the top, landing on both feet and then squatting back down. And 10 more seconds. 3, 2, 1, and squat jump. Feet shoulder width apart, squat down. Jump when you get to the top and land back in your squat. With this one, option, take out the jump and just add bodyweight squat. My mat is moving on me a little bit. Thirty more seconds. Great job. Ten. Three. Two. One, and active recovery. We have two more rounds, and then we are done. More seconds of this active recovery. And 10 more seconds. Next up, we have jumping jacks. So make that X with your body and then bring it back to center. In 3, 2, 1, and 1 minute jumping jack. 30 seconds down. Ten more seconds. Come kiss me silver and gold. Five, four, three, two, one, and rest. Active recovery. Back to our jumping jack. We have one more. We're back to our jump rope, sorry. We have one more set after this. Great job, everyone. We have 30 more seconds of our active recovery. And in 10 more seconds, we are on our last round, which is high knees. So let's finish strong in 3, 2, 1, high knees. This one, we're just bringing our knees up to the ceiling. Remember, go at the pace that you would like. Right now, I'm starting off slow, but I'm gonna get a little bit faster. And we have 30 seconds left. Let's push ourselves if we can. We're almost done. And 10 seconds. And 3, 2, 1, and rest. Woohoo! We made it through 17 minutes straight of cardio. Whew. Take some deep breaths, grab some water. Whew. I was having some technical difficulties with my music, so hope that sounded good and hope everyone's feeling good. You did it. That was definitely a challenge. Whew. Great job. So I'm going to get into our cool down. Follow along with me if you'd like. Do your own cool down. But the first one I'm going to do is just walk on my mat, walk back and forth to shake out my legs a little bit from all that jumping and just get a different feeling in them. Whew. And then after you feel good about walking it out, I'm going to come to the center of my mat. My feet are shoulder width apart. I am going to reach my hands up towards the ceiling and take a big inhale. And then I'm going to exhale and forward fold at my hips. Bring my hands towards my toes. Try to touch my toes if I can. If I can't, just get as close as I can. And then on the inhale, I'm going to come back up, reach my hands towards the ceiling. And then on the exhale, I'm going to fold forward again and release and kind of let my head hang and let my arms hang. Get that stretch in. And then one more time, I'm going to come up. And then exhale. And come down to a forward fold. This time, I'm going to grab onto my elbows. I'm going to let my head hang. And I'm going to let my arms hang. And I'm just going to hold this position. And then I'm going to come up out of it. I'm going to sit down on my mat now, and I'm going to extend my legs out in front of me. And I'm going to do a seated fold. So I'm going to reach my hands up towards the ceiling and then reach towards my toes while my legs are on the mat. And I'm going to hold. Get as close to my toes as I can. Grab onto my shins. And then from this one, I'm going to get into a butterfly pose. So I'm staying seated on the ground. And I'm bringing the bottoms of my feet together. I'm holding on to the tops of my shoes, and I'm pulling my body towards my feet. So my legs are in a butterfly position. And then for the last one, I'm going to get into a child's pose. So I'm on my hands and knees right now, and I'm going to sit my bottom back towards my feet. I'm going to extend my arms so that they're straight and my head is coming down towards my mat. And I'm going to hold this position. And then once you are out of that, that is all I have for today. Thank you for joining me for this cardio workout. Hope you got a good workout in, and we will look forward to having you next time. Thanks.